Hello, I'm Cynthia as the first speaker. In this occasion, I would like to explain about the first soup in the second chapter by Scovell, 1998. It is about no language but a cry. Some people believe babies deliver their communication by crying. If they are hungry, they will cry. If they want to sleep but they do not feel relaxed, they will cry. In the first few months of baby's life, crying is a kind of language without speech because baby communicates different type without using normal speech sound like adult. But according to Linguistic Society of America, crying is not a process of learning to talk, but it is the process of producing linguistic sound by playing around with the sound and intonation of language. There are five stages in language acquisition of child. The first, the autonomic response. The second, the ironic response. The third, symbolic response. The fourth, the cooning stage. And the last is the babbling stage. During the first few weeks of a child's life, crying is an autonomic response or primitive stage, Scovell 1998. It means the primary reflex of a spontaneous reaction. As what I have said before, baby will cry if they are hungry, feel discomfort, and etc. They will spontaneously cry as their reaction of surrounding. The second stage of the language acquisition of a child is called as iconic response. According to Scovell 1998, a baby will cry louder and longer if they feel famished. And the third, in the first or 2 months of the child development, the child will cry not only when they discomfort or pain, but rather to elicit attention, Scovell 1998, and it called as symbolic response. The fourth, according to Scovell 1998, the cooing stage is happen after several weeks of extensive interaction with baby's caretaker. This stage emerges at about 2 months of age. In this stage can only be learned in the context of interaction with adult and older children. Vygotsky in social interaction theory combines nurture arguments in that children can be influenced by their environment as well as the language input children receive from their caretaker. Meanwhile, according to Williamson 2008, children are able to use their own internal speech to direct their own behavior in the same way like their parents' speech. For example, in the research of Nobu Masataka in Scovell 1998, which show there was similarity between the sound made by mother and child. And the last stage is babbling stage. According to Scovell 1998, babbling refers to the natural tendency of children of the age about 6 months old to burst out in strings of consonant vowel syllable cluster. According to the behavior theory, language learning is a process of habit of the information and involves a trial error, where the child tries and fails to use correct language until it succeeds. Infants also provide the stimuli and reward from their environment for overt conditioning. For example, if a child starts babbling, which resembles appropriate word, then his or her babbling will be rewarded by a parent by giving positive reinforcement such as a smile or clap. Since the babbling were rewarded, this reward reinforces further articulations of the same sort into grouping of syllables and word in a similar situation. Demirzen, 1988. Okay, I think that's all for me, and the next will be continued by my friend.
Hello everyone, I'm Dian. I would like to tell you about first word. First word is a word when babies has begun to interact the word that they hear with the meaning of the word. For them, a spoken word can mean many or have different meanings, called holopress, which means the form of expressing a complex phrase or ideas into various meanings. For example, the child say dada, and the dada meanings uttered by the child can have many varieties of meanings. It could mean asking for a drink, having water, or call his father. All these meanings can be known depending on the mimic or expression, also gesture delivered by the child. For make a clear understanding about first word, it takes an example from a movie entitled The Miracle of Worker. The Miracle of Worker is a movie about a girl named Helen Keller who is mute, deaf, and blind, and has a behavior that can be considered brutal. Both of her parents have tried to heal Helen, but none of the results are satisfactory, until at last they send a letter to the Kilmson doctor from Baltimore to request a nanny to teach for Helen. And then Annie Sullivan was sent. Annie Sullivan is a woman who also almost lost her vision in childhood. When Annie first arrives at Helen's house, she meets Helen and introduces the word doll for the first time to Helen with her fingers. The activity continued to be repeated until Helen was willing to follow her. Although Helen can repeat the finger movement, she cannot fully understand what they mean. Annie Sullivan felt this house was less conducive to teach Helen's. They eventually moved to a small hut that was still part of the Helen's home. That is where Annie began teaching her various words and changing her behavior. After a while, a miracle happened. Helen could spell a few words and the sentence. At breakfast, Helen returns to her usual habit, and she gets angry, then pouring water on Annie. When Annie tries to block her, Annie leads her to a water pump and tells Helen to pump water until she feels the flow of water coming out, and that's where it is called change. As Annie pumped water over Helen's hand, Annie spilled the word water into the free hands to the girl. Something about this explained the meaning of word Helen's mind, and Annie immediately saw on her face that Helen finally understood. Helen immediately asked Annie the names of the palm to be placed on the top of her hand and then the name of the bars. Along the way home, learned the names of every she touched and also asked for a name of for Annie. Annie spelled the word teachers on Helen's hand, and finally Annie continues to be Helen's teacher. From the movie, it found two theories that can explain the movie, namely behaviorist theory and cognitive theory. The first one is behaviorist theory. Behaviorist learning theory explains that learning is a behavioral changes that can be observed, measured, and assessed concretely. Changes occur through stimuli or stimulants that can cause a relationship between reaction behavior or response. Stimulant can be known as learning environment for children, both internal and external, that cause learning, while the response is a result or impact, a cycle reaction to stimulant. There are four example takes from the movie entitled The Miracle of Worker based on behaviorist theory. The first one is Mrs. Sullivan used theory through conditioning to teach Helen to spell the word cake before giving her a cake and so forth. In addition, it's done repeatedly. The next is familiarize Helen eat using his own plate, spoon, and fork, so she became accustomed to doing it and done repeatedly until Helen able to do it. It used a theory of conditioning from behaviorist theory. The next one is Helen's mother's Katie Keller always give candy to Helen when she goes berserk in order to calm her down. Although in the end of it, Mrs. Sullivan do not agree because her mother gave gift to Helen when he made a mistake. The last one is Helen imitated what Mrs. Sullivan did. Mrs. Sullivan slapped her when Helen was at first time taught to eat with her own plate, spoon, and fork. The next theory that is found in the movie entitled The Miracle of Worker is cognitive theory. Cognitive theory can be understood as the growth of mental capacity provides mental abilities that did not exist previously. Intellectual growth is not quantitative but qualitative. In other words, the ability of thinking or mental strength of children of different age will also differ in qualitatively. Piaget, in his cognitive theory, states that children's language reflects the development of their logical thinking and reasoning skill in stage, with each period having a specific names and age references. Piaget classified the child cognitive development into four stages. The first one is sensory motor from 0 until 2 years old, then preoperational from 2 until 7 years old. The next is from egocentric and from 7 until 11 years old, and operational period from 11 until 12 years old. There are two examples taken from the movie entitled The Miracle of Worker based on cognitive theory. The first one is, cognitively, Helen would not want to learn what Annette taught to her if she did not want to decide it to be taught. Helen would not understand what Annette had taught her if she did not want it. Although the learning process can be observed directly, the learning process is also a mental activity that cannot be observed directly as well as a wish or desire. The next is, Helen Keller, when taught by Mrs. Sullivan, her age has reached 10 years old. This age, in the view of cognitive theory, is called concrete operational period. In this period, a child is able to understand themselves, to reveal the movement of their thinking from immature to mature, and from illogical to logical. In this condition, Helen cannot use the potential ability of her language vocally because she is deaf, but the power of thinking ability is still running, even smarter than other children in her age. In here, Mrs. Sullivan plays her role as a psychologist. She understands very well that Helen is a smart child, not crazy, so as not to be taken at to psychiatric hospital, she taught Helen with emphasis on mental and potential reason, which is this learning process is studied in cognitive theory.
Hello, I'm Ayumira, so I will explain about the birth of grammar related to children language acquisition. According to Charles Darwin in 1877, states that children tend to use single words as the sentences, in which this phenomenon categorized as holoprastic stage. Even though in this stage children includes intonational, gestural, and contextual clues, most psycholinguists agree that the level of it still categorizes that children use single word sentences. The example of holoprastic stage where the children use single word sentences is when they say milk, which actually refers to I'd like some milk. Children develop their communication ability through intimate social interaction. Here, holoprastic is the bridge between children's primitive land of cries to their brave new world of phrases, clause, and sentences. Children acquisition of grammar commonly related to the development of transformational generative grammar. One of the reasons why people investigate the children's language acquisition is to know how children acquire grammar. The research of children's language acquisition, which focused on acquired grammar, often found that children have amazing ability in acquiring their mother tongue fluently, in which it constructs the novel expression too. Here are the example of transformational generative grammar. Here the dialogue. Father or linguist supervising daughter getting dressed. I think you've got your underpants on backwards. The daughter. 3 years old, 9 months. Yes, I think so. The father or linguist. You'd better take them off and put them on frontwards. The daughter. Taking them off and turning them around. Is this the right words? Roger Brown in 1973 explained that children develop their grammar through different stages. Children, after the holoprostic stage, they will construct a sentence or sentences by using two words, and later on they will use more than two words. They tend to use words pivots initially or finally, and then other words will be put either after or before those words. The process of children's language acquisition in terms of requiring grammar is different with the research which is conducted on chimpanzees. The example of it, which is related to the research on chimpanzees, is derived from a project that tried to improve previous attempts to teach a form of human sign language, American Sign Language or ESL. Here, the data of the research about two words utterances by human child. It ball, it doll, it checker, it daddy, it boy. See ball, see doll, see stiff. Get ball, get doll, get baby. Their ball, their doll, their mama, their doggy, their book. One baby, one car, one do, one get, one up. These are the data of forward phrases in ESL by chimpanzee. The first is eat, drink, and then banana, nim, and then number 3, it, nim, the number 4, nim, it, number 5, banana, me, number 6, grape, it, number 7, banana, it, me, nim, number 8, banana, me, it, banana, number 9, play, me, nim, play, number 10, drink, nim. Noam Chomsky, in nativeness theory or nativist theory, described that children have an inborn or innate faculty for language acquisition in which it is biologically determined. The innateness theory proposed by Noam Chomsky is proven by the example above, which explain children under the age 3 years old, they do not speak in full sentences. When they want to say one cookie, they might say one my or I cookie. Those statements would break the syntactic structure of the phrase and component of universal grammar. The statement of that theory is the same with the example. When children use single word sentences, like when they say milk, which actually refers to I'd like some milk.
Hello, I'm Arista. Now I would like to continue the presentation. It is about the evidence for innateness. One of the evidence for innateness is most of the psycholinguists believe that the things which is influencing the human language acquisition is not only a child's environment. It is proven by the experiment done between Nim Chimpsky, which is a chimpanzee, and human child. This experiment is conducted in order to know the language acquisition occurred from those are the two primates. If it is influenced by the environment, especially the reward from someone who appreciated the way Nim and human child produced the language, so Nim will be the better between both of them. It is because Nim always frequently provided by the sign and was continually rewarded and reinforced by the handler whenever he used the sign in order to communicate. Meanwhile, the human child was infrequently rewarded and reinforced only for speaking up. In spite, sometimes they are encouraged to be seen but not heard. From these kinds of argument made, Chomsky and other generation of psycholinguists claim that a sizable part of early linguistic learning comes from an innately specified language ability in human beings. It means that every human being is already had their own language ability since they were born. It is also understood as the way we learn about our mother tongue is very different from learning to play guitar or learning to dance. Why? It is because there is a language device existed in human brain, so they can automatically learn about language. This language mechanism is called LAD, or language acquisition device. Meanwhile, when we learn to play guitar and to dance, we are not automatically known how to learn it, but the innate areas in our brain which help us to learn the key of guitar tone and the movement of dance. From those of the examples, we can relate this example to the theory of historical theories, especially innateness theory. According to Noam Chomsky's innateness theory, stated that children are already have an innate faculty of language acquisition in their brain, which is determined in biologically. It means that the human's brain is consisted of neural circuits which is contain linguistic information and it can be triggered by hearing speech. Chomsky also explained that biologically in child's brain is already built the language mechanism which is led the child's brain to learn the language. This language mechanism called LAD or language acquisition device, which uses for working out the rules of language. The example of LAD. LAD is already provided by the concept of verb tense. When the child heard the word form such as eating and drinking, the child will automatically form a hypothesis that present continuous tense of verb are formed by adding the sound ing at the end of the word. Thus, if the next time the child will use ing in forming present continuous word without example before, then it can be concluded that the LAD, which is existed in child's brain, which is genetically innateness, can help the child itself to be able to learn their language. Furthermore, this mechanism of language also can help the child to learn how to play guitar by understanding the key tone and how to dance by focusing on the movement and the music. Therefore, the theory of innateness proposed by Noam Chomsky has a tight relationship to the evidence for innateness.
Hello, I'm Sinta. I would like to continue to the next material, which is about Childe's creativity.
In this session, a child language acquisition is not dependent on the environment influences. It comes from the child's mind, or it can be said that children acquire their language independently. But of course, children will first need to understand the word's meaning and grammar before they can construct their own creativity in acquiring the language from the people around them. For example, one day, somebody comes to a 2-year-old child's house and is at the door of their house. The child who realizes it tells her mother that somebody's at the door. However, her mother answers it with, "There's nobody at the door." To convey that her mother is wrong, the child answers back with, "There's his body at the door." This example tells us that the child understands the meaning of the word "no" and "body," as well as "nobody," which means no one comes to their house or is at the door of their house. The child especially pay attention to the word "no" in "nobody," which means no one is there. Then, the child must have prior knowledge of the opposite word of "no," which is "yes," because he thinks that "yes" can be used to convey that there really is a person at the door. However, the child thinks that "no" in "nobody" can be replaced directly using "yes," which becomes "yes, buddy," to say that there is somebody at their house in range. Although it is understandable for her mother, it is not right use and form of the language that she learns. The process in which the child changed the word "no" into "yes" to construct a new word "yes, buddy" is the child's creativity in constructing their language. Children are almost like a well-programmed computers, even though they often make inaccurate guesses about the rules and the pattern of the language, but their language is still acceptable. For example, there is a 3-year-old child who observed his parents welcoming their friends, and someone said, "There's Carlos." The pattern is "there's" plus noun. And others said, "There he is." The pattern is "there's" plus pronoun plus is. After the child heard these exclamations and understand the meaning of each word as well as the pattern of the sentences, the child exclaimed, "There Carlos is." The pattern "there" plus noun plus is. From how the child construct his sentence, it can be concluded that the child know the patterns of the sentences and the words class in each sentence. It is because the child correctly substitute the pronoun "he" with the noun "Carlos." He know that the word "he" can be replaced with a person's name, while the patterns might because he tried to imitate the patterns of the sentence spoken before. This may because the child overgeneralized the pattern used by the speakers. Thus, the child's sentence is grammatically wrong, but sounds almost acceptable. This process of constructing new patterns in a sentence after understanding the correct patterns of the language is also a part of children's creativity. These examples of children's creativities can be explained further using cognitive theory. Cognitive theory is a theory developed by Jean Piaget, who said that children need to actively construct their own understanding on a concept of everything in the world before they can acquire and use the language to express the concept of it. So they also need to learn from their interaction with their environment. Once they understand the language generally from their environment, that knowledge will become their prior knowledge to construct the language further. In the first example, the 2-year-old child understands that the word "nobody" consists of the word "no" and "body." She also know the meaning of these words and know that when using the word "no" means conveying that there is no one at the door of her house. The reason is because she automatically used the opposite word of "no," which is "yes," to tell her mother that someone is really at the door of their house. However, she did not know that combining the word "yes" with "body" will not create the correct language. She used this because the child thought that it is the correct form for saying "there is someone at their entrance" from copying and reconstructing her mother's sentence. From the situation, it can be concluded that the child understands the meaning of each of her mother words, the pattern of the language, and how to make new language or word that is understandable. The child also has prior knowledge about the pattern of the language and know how to use it as how it is, because she did not change the pattern of the sentence, even though she changed the form of a word. So, the child has cognitive ability in acquiring the language to construct what she has known and understand from observing the people around her. The second example can also be explained further using cognitive theory. As explained before, in the example, the child has prior knowledge on the meaning of the words, the patterns, and the word category in the sentences. The child used one of the patterns without changing the position of the words, for the child imitated from the speakers. The child can even correctly guess the pronoun he can be replaced with the noun or a name Carlos. The usage of the word there and is are from imitating and copying the pattern used by the speakers before. So here, the child attentively observed the speaker's sentences to construct new sentence that the child thought as the correct grammar. Thus, it concluded that cognitive theory has a relation with children's language acquisition, in which the children creatively construct their grammar based on what they have learned and on what they can plausibly assume. Besides constructing new word and sentence pattern, children's creative construction also reflect their inborn sensitivity to the synthetic structure of the language they are acquiring. In other words, the statement refers to the relation between children's creativity with innateness theory. Innateness theory is a theory proposed by Noam Chomsky, which explained that children have innate or inborn competence for language acquisition. It is biologically determined, so it refers to the trait had by the children since born. In innateness theory, it is also explained that human's brain has its own linguistic informations at birth to learn a language, which is triggered by hearing speech. So actually, the children already has linguistic information since they was born. And they learn a language because they hear the language since they was born too. It is the natural function of the brain. Because there is information entering their brain from their ears, the brain will try to proceed it automatically. For example, the word hiccup and the word hiccup are phonologically indistinguishable. Or in other words, it sounds the same. The children can only depend on their self and their ears to distinguish these words. The reason are, first, they still could not be taught using explanation. And second, they cannot read yet. So, their innate ability will decide their ability to acquire the language and how they construct the language. It also happens while trying to distinguish the sound of the word interrupt and interrupt, for the sounds of both words are almost the same. It is the child's brain quality that determines how well the child can receive the information. Thus, innateness theory also influences children's creativity in constructing their language. Okay, I think that's all from me. The next material will be presented by my friend.
Stage of linguistics development. Stage of linguistics development is about language acquisition of the children with varied stage. This stage of language acquisition is beginning from 4 months to 5 years old. Children start to learn about language that already explained. The children learn language acquisition from their mother or their environment interaction. The theory that related to language acquisition is behaviorism. There are 5 stages of language acquisition. Those are cooing, begin from 4 months. Babbling, begin from 6 to 9 months. One word U-turns, begin from 12 months. telegraphic speech begin from 2 years old, and the last is normal speech begin from 4 to 5 years old. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.